this week has been extremely exhausting. It's been extremely tiring. It's been a very sorry, sad week. And of course, today was declared a national day for mourning our Lake Victoria boat cruise victims. And let's just say, as a nation, this has shown me a lot. It has shown me how we can be together. It has shown me how humans in Uganda, their levels of savagery are a whole nother level. And it scares me that we find the fun in everything. What does that say about us? Are we dealing with so much that we have decided to be insensitive when we have to? I don't know. There are people who are writing up very long posts and people who are making memes and, you know, catching a joke or two from this whole situation. I'm like, yo, I guess we all have a way we deal with grief. That's one thing I learned at a very tender age. We all have a different way we deal with grief. Some people laugh, some people cry, some people become a recluse. Anywho, welcome to Scoop and Scoop. And of course, given it's a Friday, we have to definitely do what's right. Get yourself a copy of the Kampala Sun. Today's edition is fire. And it has a little bit of answers to all of you who have been looking for certain, you know, answers. Now, of course, it has a tribute to Chuck, the last king of slayers in Uganda. And honestly speaking, Bambi, Chuck Yalumabanji, I didn't even know him. Did you know him? And Cruising to Death, that's of course our big headline here. It says Prince Wasaja tried to stop the trip before it actually did go or went underway. The boat captain got into a fight with the boat owner. And the Kwagalana's free man, Kwagalana Group, for all of you who know what that means, say he paid $7 million for the trip. Now, from what I'm hearing and from the few people that we have, you know, spoken to or talked to who were on that boat, first of all, you have to understand, because when they said $7 million, I was like, what? $7 million to sit on a rickety thing and sail haphazardly off into the sunset? No, $7 million was too much. And then they explained to me it was an invite only situation. Everybody you see at that boat was invited personally or some way. Now, the $7 million catered for the cruise, catered for the food, drink. They had everything paid for. All you had to do is show up, because the rich money bags were like, you know what, let us have a good time, we'll pay for everything. So there's that aspect. Why, according to me, for $7 million, I believe for $7 million, if I could spend $7 million on just feeding people and dressing and you know, just letting them have a good time, I believe if I can afford $7 million to just let people make merry, I can definitely afford extra cash to make sure they're doing it safely, you know, on a better ferry or a yacht or whatever. Now, in the Kampala Sun, there's another guy who was actually a survivor too, and he is narrating his ordeal. And judging from his narrative, and when I juxtapose it next to Irene Namubiru's narrative, there's something a bit lacking. And when I juxtapose those two to different narratives that were on the board, the survivors, it's a little bit confusing. Irene, I'm trying to understand. In your statement, this is me just trying to figure things out. In your statement, you said you noticed. Okay, now you gave a full rundown of what went down. Let me try to break it down to the most crucial moments. You said when the boat flipped over, you fell overboard. When you fell overboard, there was another kaboat, a kakanoo, around. Wait, is that it? There was a canoe when you fell overboard. That's why you were among the first few people to be rescued. It was you, Prince Wasaja, and, you know, a few other people there. So you were among the first people to get on the canoe. But let us not forget, you fell overboard. So when you fall overboard, you fell with your bag and your phone. But then again, you're the same person telling us, after you fell overboard and you were rescued and put on the canoe, you were using your phone to give light. Now, that's possible. It is definitely possible. It's not that every phone that falls in the lake is gonna get spoiled like that. Some phones are waterproof, and I think she had one of them. But then this is what is confusing me. When you fell overboard, you are holding the phone how? Like, because this is very traumatizing for you to even care much for a phone. How did you fall in with this Ford? How did it not slip out of your hands, given of the chaos that was around you? Mm-hmm. Now, mbuza bibuzo. And then after that whole incident, you say, in one statement, you come and you say, wayambako no tochingira, the people who are helping to rescue other people in the water. In another statement, you say they got the phone from you, the guy who actually rescued you got the phone from you and he was helping other fishermen to help get some people out of the water. So which is which? I don't want you to think like I'm starting, I'm on a personal vendetta. No, I'm just trying to say, girl, if you're gonna come out and tell the truth and nothing but the truth. Because now I feel you are just milking this story for your own, I don't know what you're gaining from it, because it's already sad. It's sad that you can lie through your teeth while we see it. We sat with one of the survivors and he has a different story to tell. Now his story is a little bit, woo child, it's one of them. It's one of them that gets tinabole. For real, why aren't they saying these things? Now according to this source, who of course I can't name, he says, when the boat took off, they didn't just go straight to where everything happened, you know? When the boat took off, they say they stopped at nearby the first island they stopped on. Midway into the journey, they stopped by a nearby island. On that nearby island, about 10 rich men got off and they all had their side pieces. Now, according to, by the way, this is rumor. According to this source, though she stands by her word, Mbugwe. Anyway, she says, among the 10 people that got off the boat, there happened to be an Irene Namubiru. And I'm like, wait, are you getting my drift here? So, no, na story, that is why I'm trying to ask myself, who is saying the truth? Now, someone comes to my attention and says, Beba Nonya, they're already in Kampala blasting. Not all of them are dead. I was like, what? That's so cool. Why would you let the world, you know, look and mourn? Because half of the people were there under different pretentious reasons. Half of the people that were there, well, they were not supposed to be there. So when tragedy hit, according to some people who were actually at the scene, the very first few people that were rescued disappeared off into the middle of the night. Because one, they knew the media was going to make it a scandal and you cannot begin explaining yourself. Two, they just didn't know how to deal. Mugenda kufanga temumanyi chivati sawa sile queen ne king. Mugenda kufa. Ate muchafa. Inu nyangole, my mother used to say, waretera hokwe tenga. Bekina hokwe gombanga inyo. The youngest generation is one. That's it. That's just it. Abana baba ndiva food day. Oli nagenda ku campus anonyo mwana we. Nima mugamba mwana. Now, I was she went for that boat cruise. Like, wait, what? How? Do you get my drift here? Like, I don't. Anyway, it is what it is. May their souls rest in peace. But as they are resting in peace, I will not rest a minute until I get the peace. That's the part I'm trying to get. I want to get the peace. And for me to get the peace, I'm going to know what exactly it is that is being hidden. The ever legendary Genie Wine is in town. I saw him and I was like, what? He grew fat.
I just had to say that.
According to what we knew, the news that we knew is that Genie Wine was going to be sleeping at Speak Resort Munyonyo, and that is where the whole thing was going to take place, isn't it? Because the whole advertising has been, it's going to be at Speak Resort Munyonyo. Now I wake up today morning to a different situation. And they're saying, no, he is not at Munyonyo. We're actually not holding the press conference at Munyonyo. We're holding it at Miss Steel. I'm like, wait, what's happening? And then before I know it, rumors start circulating that the reason why all of this is happening, Mbu, Chaka Mayanja has disappeared. Simanya, he doesn't want to pay suppliers. Simanya, Baba Itabatia, service providers. So he's in the wind and they don't know if the concert will be held tomorrow. I'm like, really? Now, there's very few people, the very, very, very few people, very few people in Uganda I can trust with HIV. Bala. Nchimua. No matter what you do, bala me HIV, so she jump happening. Next person I know, Shaka Mayanja. Shaka Mayanja is very present because as before I came on air, we did actually go for the press conference and Shaka was available, the artist was available. So for me, that is simple. It means that you're going to call it. So I don't understand where it's all coming from. But let's wait until tomorrow. Let's just wait. And if it doesn't happen, don't worry. I'll give you the nitty gritty. But if it happens, I'll still give you the nitty-gritty of how it happened. That's just my job. At TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop and at TinaFierce1. Don't forget, on Instagram, we are Scoop and Scoop. Wait, Instagram, do I have to say Scoop and Scoop? Oh, no. On Instagram, it's at TinaFierce1 with an H. Like and follow all these different platforms. And if you do have something that you want to share with us, it's quite simple. Hit me up on each and any one of those platforms. I'll definitely get back to you personally because I'm cool like that. Yeah, I'm really cool. I'm out. Catch you Monday and be safe. Peace.